So here we are, Winter NAMM 2016, with the one and only Mr. Bob Weil. How are you?
Good to see you, Lewis.
Good to see you.
Mr. Tone King.
President and CEO of now True Tone,
exactly.
Which was formerly...
Formerly known as Visual Sound, formerly known as Prince.
I didn't know the Prince part.
Yeah, that's a little known fact.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Well, I think you hit the mark with True Tone. That's,
thanks, man.
You know,
yeah.
Tone and...
It's a lot easier to remember. I mean, honestly, the big reason why we changed the name was because, you know, people couldn't remember Visual Sound. They remembered one spot. They remembered Jekyll and Hyde, Route 66. But, you know, I would meet them and I'd say, you know, hey, I'm Bob Weil, I'm the owner of Visual Sound. They go, Visual Sound, what do you guys make? You know,
nice.
Oh, well, we make the one spot. Oh, yeah, I've got like two of those or three of them. I'm like, so I did a great job naming the products. I did a terrible job naming the company, obviously. So
how's it resonating?
This is a lot easier. Honestly, people are digging it.
Yeah.
Ever since we came out with the new True Tone name back in March of 2015, people just immediately gravitated to it. They got it.
Nice.
I had acquired the trademark about 10 years ago. And took some time, but we got some other URLs, and TrueTone.com we finally got. With Visual,
yeah, your other one was .net.
VisualSound.net, which was annoying, you
yeah.
know. So, anyhow, we got away from that, and this is going great.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Well, that's good to hear.
Thanks, man.
So, tell me what's new, or whatever you'd like to talk about for this NAMM show. This, you hadn't been here the last 3 years, but you're here this year.
That's right.
So,
yeah.
I'm going to hand you the mic. Tell us what's new.
Oh, okay, sure. Should I look at you or the camera?
No, let's look at the middle.
That's even better. Yeah, as you can see, almost nothing here is ours, but that's not why we're showing it. We're showing it to demonstrate the capability of the OneSpot Pro CS12 model, which is the 12 output, five different voltages available on there, 9, 12, 18 volt DC, you got the 4 to 9 volt adjustable for old style fuzzes, and you even have a 9 volt AC output, which is completely unique to this power supply. Nobody else does that. We got that today. We got that powering an old Digitech whammy pedal here. We could have powered the M9 with it, but we're actually just using a high current 9 volt DC to power that. We've also got, you know, Eventide and Strymon and all these pedals that would never get along on a daisy chain because they're digital and, you know, and all that, and they actually require isolation. Some of them are running at 18 volts. Some of them are running at 12 volts. This guy's running at, you know, somewhere between 4 and 9. You know, it's just, it's a real hodgepodge, which this really caters to, and it's the only power supply out there that can do that. Plus, it's using our own one-spot technology, which technically is switching power supply technology. We're the first ones to ever do that. We actually had to invent the technology in this application from scratch. It took us 3 years to do it, but I've got a couple of brilliant engineers who are way smarter than me, and they figured out how to do it and how to keep it super quiet. So, totally unique power supply. And it's also got a little brother, the CS7. That's seven outputs. It has 18 volt, 9 volt, 12 volt. It can handle, with both of these power supplies, they can actually handle more than what it says on the silkscreen label there, unlike other power supplies. Because all the other power supplies out there, Pedal Power and other ones, other copies of it, they all just use a transformer in a box. Ours is using, you know, digital switching power supply technology, which is super quiet, super powerful. So even though it says, like on here, 200 milliamps for that output, you could pull 400 out of that easily, and it won't even break a sweat. In fact, here's a picture of another pedal board with some big Strymon pedals on it and some other stuff. This is, belongs to our friend in Nashville, a guy named Austin, who gigs five nights a week. He's been gigging five nights a week the last 4 months with a OneSpot Pro CS7. He used to use a Pedal Power Mondo in there, but it was so heavy it actually would rip the screws out of his pedal train. Yeah, so the OneSpot Pro comes with brackets that are designed to mount under pedal train pedal boards. So anyhow, I'm pretty stoked about it. A lot of people are getting them. They're solving a lot of problems, a lot of shortcomings of other power supplies, and they're you know, a lot of people use the regular OneSpot, the little OneSpot that I came out with 16 years ago. You got two of them? That's awesome. Thank you. And a lot of people use those because they do solve many needs for many people. But for people that have pedals that are 18 volts or 9 volts AC or really need isolation, this solves that problem, you know, perfectly.
When you have two or three or four boss pedals and you just need to make them go, that one spot solves the problem real quick.
Yeah. Yeah.
So where could they buy this?
Actually, I would say either go to your local store and ask for it if they don't have it. A lot of local stores do have it now, actually. You can also go online to, like, guitarfxpedals.com, Sweetwater, There's a number of websites that carry it as well. Chicago Music Exchange and Reverb, them as well. I mean, lots of other ones. But yeah, you can get it anywhere. It'll totally solve your pedal problems easily and quietly.
There you go. Yeah. So anything? So we covered some. Can we come over here real quick?
Over here? Yeah.
So we covered this one for 30 pedals in 30 days.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. I actually covered these in the past. I haven't covered that one. Do we have anything else in the...
In the works?
Yeah.
Actually, you remember the dual tap delay?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Yeah, we've got a new dual tap delay coming out later this year. I can't say what month yet because we're still working on it, but it's going to be smaller, lighter.
This form factor?
Yes, that form factor. Sorry. That form factor, but a little bit wider so that we can accommodate the 3-foot switches.
Okay. But, so you're kind of doing a rework on all of them with the new True Tone name.
Yeah, not on all of them, but on certain ones that we know people really want, you know?
Yeah, I really like these pedals, the routing capabilities, the 2-in-1, and this one was a favorite for 30 pedals right here. If you haven't checked out the Jekyll and Hyde video, do be sure to check that one out. That was a favorite. Impressive looking pedals too. They sound good, but they're very well thought out as well.
Thanks, man. Yeah, we put a lot of effort into these to make them really indestructible as well as sound great. And that's why we offer a lifetime warranty on them, which nobody else does that, because why would you if the switches are going to break?
The forever switch.
Yeah, the forever foot switch, that'll last for 10 million hits, so you can do this for the rest of your life, it's still going to work.
There you go.
But you might get tired.
Let's do a quick, just for those that maybe haven't had a chance to listen to those, what's the difference between this, and that in a sentence or two?
For the three dirt pedals, yeah. The Route 66 is compression and overdrive. So, one channel is not a drive, but it's compressor with a clean mix knob on it, which is just killer for that. You can crank the sustain, dial back the clean mix, and it'll sound like it's not even compressing, but it'll sustain for days, or you can squash the heck out of it, whatever you want to do. The drive on that is actually based on the old Reverend drivetrain pedal, which I designed for Reverend years ago, and we actually made it for him and everything. And that became the Garage Tone drivetrain that we made for a while, and now it's in here. But with a clean mix knob.
Okay.
Jekyll and Hyde, the Hyde channel didn't change a whole lot, but we added a voice switch to it, which I'm really glad we did. That was based on an artist recommendation that we had some years ago. Yeah, a guy who had clipped a diode just out of the circuit, and it sounded a certain way, and we tried it and dug it, so that's in there.
There you go.
The other channel is based on the Open Road, but we added a clean mix knob again, and also a bass knob, and a little bit more mid-range than the old Open Road had, too, but it's a very organic, ampy kind of sound. On the XO, the right channel started out as our Route 808, which was our sort of sweetened and amped up version of an old Route TS-808 kind of thing.
Right.
But then we kind of got carried away with features. We added a clean mix, of course. Added a clipping switch, which is basically three different voices of diode clipping. Three different bass setting levels. And then the other channel is, again, Open Road. No clean mix on it this time, but with a bass knob. And a little bit more mid-range than the Open Road. So it's a pretty wide array of dirt to work with.
So it's actually kind of funny hearing you, kind of go through like the XO that it was modeled on other pedals you created in the Jekyll Hyde. You should create a whole other series that are based on these that are then based on... You just keep going, That's a lot of fun.
We kind of have done that over the years. I mean, if you remember from way back, like 20, almost 20 years ago, the first Jekyll and Hyde was silver.
Right.
It was flat top and it was shaped like home plate,
Yeah.
And then we just simply decided to paint it red, and we sold more of them because they were red. I don't know why. And then we came up with the V2 series, which really did change a lot of things, and then and now the V3 series. So we've been tweaking it all these years,
The evolution of man thing?
Yeah.
The shows like the little man, they get bigger and bigger. You need to do that for your pedals, to show like where it all began.
Evolution?
Yeah.
Actually, I did that with Visual Volume, which was the first thing I ever invented 20-some years ago. And the evolution of that is just comical, because I started out with like a wood block prototype that wasn't even shielded, so it hummed like crazy. It was just awful because I didn't know what I was doing. It was like 25 years ago. I wasn't educated. But and then it got better and more refined until it actually looked like a professional product after a while,
Are you, is that one out here?
Visual Volume, no. We're actually not making it right now.
Okay.
We're hoping to make a new, improved or different version in another year or two.
Gotcha.
Yeah, we're sort of letting it rest for a little bit.
Can't wait to see that one. So, there it is, Winter NAMM 2016. Thank you so much for...
Lewis, thank you, man. I really appreciate all your support. Your videos are great.
Thank you. My pleasure. Later.